think about the idea. It's incredible, but it does appear to be possible to create individuals that have very high genetic similarity to species that have gone extinct.
One of the big challenges in environmental ethics right now is the fact that, and for the world, is the fact that extinction rates are so high. They're about 10,000 times what the normal background rates are. And so people are thinking of lots of new ways to try to prevent species from going extinct, and now maybe even bring back some species that were extinct. So it's an extension of my work on environmental ethics, and it's a pretty exciting new idea.
How many people here have heard of de-extinction?
The question we were looking at last night is how good a new idea is. Definitely exciting, but the question is it good?
I mean, think about this. We don't have any existing models for what these species do. What does a mammoth do? I mean, we have some ideas, right? But it's going to be much harder than if we're breeding elephants or something like that, which we have a pretty good idea about.
There are a lot of animals that have been extinct so long that the DNA information doesn't exist, so that we can't even begin to try to reassemble the code and bring it back. So, sadly, no dinosaurs. But woolly mammoths would be great. I think that would be really exciting and interesting and wondrous. For my own part, I like birds, so it would be nice to see an ivory-billed woodpecker.
Everything I'm about to say, I learned from Professor Vogel.
From a conservation perspective, it's really not that important. It's much more important to prevent species from going extinct. It's much more important to address the causes of extinction, like habitat destruction and climate change, and to be able to bring back one or two species that we find particularly compelling. From a conservation perspective, it's not anything to get too excited about. But from a techno-science perspective, as a technological achievement, as a statement about human ingenuity, it's a pretty amazing thing. I mean, it would be a wondrous thing to be able to go see a passenger pigeon or a Tasmanian tiger or a woolly mammoth or something like this. I mean, this would be the very idea that we're even have people actively working on trying to resequence genomes of extinct species and clone them and bring back living organisms that have highly similar genetic material. I mean, that's just quite incredible, really.
And it's a philosophical issue. It's not a technical
issue. It was exciting. It was great. It was nice to be able to see the faculty again, to be able to hear what's been going on at the school, to hear what's going on in their lives, to hear what the students are up to, and share a little bit about what I've been working on and what I've been doing.
What if we mess up and do something that's catastrophic?
So it just seems to me to be like a different question. Like, I
understand. I was really struck yesterday about how the high quality of the student questions and the ways in which they were thinking about how these things mattered in the real world to the real problems that we were trying to address.
Okay. That's it. Thank you.